Indeed. Now, we've heard the term peak oil, peak water. A report out this morning questions all of that kind of language. The Adam Smith Institute is claiming the world is not running out of valuable minerals, for example, after all. It says claims from environmentalist groups are based on a misunderstanding of terminology. For example, the reserves for minerals used in fertilizers, such as phosphate and potassium, may exhaust in the next few decades, but the exhaustion of resources won't happen for, well, thousands of years. Director of the Adam Smith Institute, Dr. Eamonn Butler, is with us. Good morning to you.
Hello.
You say reserve, I say resource, potato, potato. Explain the difference.
The difference is, it's like this. We call it the no breakfast family fallacy, that you have a certain amount of food in the fridge, maybe 2 or 3 days. And what many environmentalists are saying is after you use that food, then we're all going to starve because there isn't any more food. But in fact, there's a whole industry out there which is working to keep your fridge stocked, and you can go to the supermarket and restock it. So that's the difference between reserves and resources. Reserves are what you're working on today. They're the current working stock that you're going to exploit in the next 10, 20, 30 years. Resources are the stuff that's out there that you know that's out there.
How do you know it's out there?
You know it's out there because you've done some surveying, you know that you can exploit that, that it's accessible, but it's really not worth today going into real detailed investigation for something that you're not going to need for another 280 years.
So you can tell me with great accuracy exactly how much oil is left on the planet Earth?
The more that we use it, the more that we need it, then the more we discover. It's like shale oil, for example, that we thought we were running out of oil.
I mean, there's got to be a finite amount, isn't it?
No.
The laws of physics tell us that there's got, there's only so many atoms out there.
Yes, but you can use other things as well, and when the price goes up, then people swap to different things. I mean, when I was small, all my toys were made of tin plate. Now toys are made of plastic.
Are you actually saying that our, sort of, for example, when we try and recycle stuff and be parsimonious in our use of it, that is actually a bad thing because it is wasteful?
Not at all. If it makes economic sense, then we should do it. 99.9% of the world's gold is recycled. We recycle lead, we recycle aluminium. There's an awful lot of stuff we don't recycle because it simply isn't worth bothering.
So what is the damage that's being done by getting this wrong? It just can't hurt to hang on to stuff and be, recycle it.
Yes, it does, because it means that you're paying more for resources which are actually quite plentiful and that you can exploit in the future.
All right. Dr. Eamonn Butler, Director of the Adam Smith Institute, thank you very much indeed.
Thanks, Simon. 27 minutes past.